Okay, so we have a castigative profile in here, and this is post photon hypernova, where we get where in TCC they get this some new Castira card. Let's say in this this staircase, this scarecrow Castira, this Reichard, Papias, Paraisos, this is the important one. Also this Reichard, this is a post monster in this deck post photon hypernova. Okay, so let's start for the Castira monster first. Yeah, you need to play three Castira Unicorn. This is a main piece monster in this deck, because you can one card combo with this card. With this card, you can search this Papias and summon Vendir from Papias target your Unicorn, and Vendir search this Reichard, special Reichard, and you need to exit Unicorn plus Vendir into Shangri-La and use this Reichard effect to banish Big Bang, and then banish three opponent top deck, and increase, and this Reichard level become 7, and you can trigger this Big Bang to special one of this Vendir or Unicorn from your Shangri-La material. Okay, so please remember this reset is the penis card is cost. Yeah, it's cost. So even though opponent get it, you can still special summon. You can still trigger a Big Bang from your pension. And you can still summon this unicorn on Vendir from Shangri-La material. So this the good part about this card. Next, three Vendir. If you don't open a unicorn, you can still make Vendir search reset and make rank 7. This is also second best card in this deck, and you can banish any opponent first up card, and this strong card to interrupt opponent play. Next, I use only one tier cast, and this is just another name in this deck. And sometimes if you have a reset on the field, you can summon this tier cast and mill three opponent deck. So it will banish three opponent deck. Yeah, sometimes it's good because it's a different name with this Scarecrow Castira. The reason I use two, because you can attack with this card in defense position, so it's the good interaction with this Papias, because if you use Papias, you need to summon your Castira in defense position. So in some situation, you can summon this Scarecrow and OTK with it. Also, I play 2 because sometimes you can set this odd one plus this tier cast. You can set this 2 to undercards. And I think you don't need to play more than this, because you need a card in hand or grave to special summon it. So it's a bit hard to use this effect. The only reason you play this because you need this to finish your Papias in grave, and Papias will trigger when this card is finished. You can cycle back your face up Castira card in your pension. So that's why you need to use this too. If you want to only play one Scarecrow, it's fine. And next, this Reichard, you can play 2 or 3, but for now, because you have a full power Castira, 2 it's enough. You don't want to break to open multiple discard. And let's move into hand trap, I think. Shifter, base hand trap in this deck. And it's fully strong against tier with full power, and it also strong versus any deck. And the underhand trap, I try to play 3S and 3 mourner, The reason about this is because both are level 3 and you build to summon Baron with it. So let's say you summon Unicorn on Vendor and summon one of this hand trap because it's level 3, so you can summon Baron before you full combo. It also depend with your hand. If you have full combo hand, you can start with Baron first and avoid Nibiru. The good thing about this is, as it sometimes is bad because, yeah, you can only negate opponent let's say in intermatch up you can negate opponent Reinhardt or maybe this Palreimo. It's not a much card to negate with it, but in under match, let's say flow or under deck, S is really really strong. And yeah, in tier rating, I usually set this out and set in under card. I use this because it's level 3, also you can still use it under shifter or rise heart. Because you don't need to discard this to grave to use the effect. So, Valor is strong, but you need, but if you have a shifter and a reserve, you cannot use Valor, so that's why I put S instead. And next, Mourner. Third best hand trap. So, first best hand trap is shifter, second is Imper, and third this one. Once again, the reason is it's level 3 and it's like Valor. So in the mess up, you can get opponent Kid Kalos. You can wait opponent to use Kid Kalos. And in Castera mess up, you can get opponent when they start with Unicorn on Vendor. You can just negate it. If you want to use S in Castera Mirror, you need to use it when opponent try to use Paraisos or Papias. But if you use Papias and they control this Unicorn, your opponent will to banish your extra monster. So you need to be careful, but I think because it's no problem, I think, if they banish one of this extra deck. So yeah, S is really strong in mirror match. Next, move into spell. I think I will move into Castera spell first. 3 Papias mandatory. It's really really strong cards. You can spell summon any Castera with different name from deck. Also, the good part about this card is if this card is banished, you can cycle back your Castera card and it have a good interaction between this and Reset, cause you can if this card is in banished zone, you can attach this to this Reset, and after if you use Reset, you can attach this Papias and it will trigger the effect Papias, and you can cycle your Castera, any Castera card in your banished zone. So that's why this card is really really strong. Next, 3 Parasios is mandatory. You can search any Castera monster from deck to your hand. Also, your monster will gain 100 attack and defense. It's for its attribute on the field, so it's boost your attack monster. Also, if you Sangrila is use it effect, you can destroy one card on the field. So this is another good effect, but it's really rare to use this card because Sangrila usually use it effect when in stand PPS or when opponent finish a face down. So next, I think I will move into this last Castera card in main deck is Big Bang. It's really strong. If this card is finished, you can target one Castera in your control and add one Castera there in material, and you can special summon it. So this is really strong combo with Sangrila and Reset. You can banish this with Reset and special summon your Sangrila in your Sandhya material. Also, if you can also use this card on the field. So if you control Kasira exit monster, make put player penis monster face down until they only control one. So this is really strong. It's like evenly matched. So let's reopen and try to make a huge support. And if you only need one Shangri-La or maybe this Rise Heart, if you only control Shangri-La, you can use ship. And it also triggers Shangri-La effect to lock opponent zone. Next, if you control this Rise Heart, you can banish all face stone and it will trigger this Rise Heart. To attach, you can attach this big bang, and later if you use if you detach this big bang, it also trigger it, and you can special summon one of those Kasira in this reset material. So it also have interaction with the reset. So big bang is mandatory in my deck. Next, under staple terraforming because Parasios. I also try to play set rotation because you have this necrophile. It's really strong can steer, and if you don't need it, you can you can give it to your opponent to opponent field. Okay, so I forget to mention this, but this is like monster ribbon in this Kasira. You can summon level 7 from penis or Grave, and I only play 2 because 2 it's a good ratio in this full power because you don't need to break. Also in some situation you can also summon level 7 from hand. And next, if opponent is activated spell trap or a spell craft card or effect, you can banish 3 opponent grave face down. It will banish face down, so it will trigger Shangri-La 2. And this card is really strong against Terlamen Scream. So if you control this and Kasira, it's really, really strong against Tyr. And let's move into Wonder Staple. I'll try to play one tasking and one talent. I'll try to play 1-1 because I believe people will play a lot of hand trap, so you can use tasking. Even though in first turn you can still set the Imper or this Big Bang because this two is normal trap. And in their matchup, if they try to summon like Hafnis, you can also use this to search either talent, you can search terraforming, you can search prosperity, you can also search Papias. This is the strongest one. So there is a lot of target with this tasking, especially when you going second. And next, 3 Imper. I think this is one of the best hand trap right now. This deck, this is a second best hand trap. You can get anything you want with it. In their matchup, you can get opponent Kid Kalos or maybe Reno Heart, but Kid Kalos is a best target for this card. In Mirror, you can get opponent like Rise Heart, your opponent Unicorn, anything. And next, move into Extra. Think I'll start with this Baron. I play Baron because I play 6 level 3 Tanner, and with this card you don't need to worry about Nibiru. And next, I play Donor because it can destroy itself, so you can free summon your Vanir or Unicorn from hand. And in Mirror Match is really strong against opponent Reshard. Also, you can out opponent Bagusca with it. Next, Black Lash of Soldier. This is in some situation you need a big monster like this because you have a lot of level 7. And if you summon this PLS with level 7 or higher, this card cannot be target opponent card effect. Also, it cannot destroy by effect. Then if this cat is the sort of an monster, bipedal, you can use one of this effect. You can 1500, and you can make this cat the second deck during next battle phase. So it's the second effect is really weird, and yeah. And next is banish one cat on the field. So the first and the third effect is really really strong. Next, I try to play Emerald because yeah, okay, so I forget to mention about this property. I think you need to play this because it's yeah, it helps you to make your deck is more consistency. You can banish anything you want from extra, and because of this reset, you can cycle back your banish zone with it. Also, that's why I play this Emerald. The way you can only summon this is from 2 Rise Heart, because it's level 4. And sometimes it's, in theory, when you're in a trading game, when you already use all of your extra tech, let's say you already use your extra tech from Prosperity, you can make this and cycle back your extra tech from grave, and later you can use it again. So that's why I don't need to worry about use 3 prosperity. Next, 2 Shangri-La, I think 2 is a good ratio. It's you need to play this because it's a main combo in this deck. Sometimes you can only make a Shangri-La and end base, but I think it's fine because if this card is destroyed by battle or effect, you can detach one of this material. So yeah, this is a big defend, and you can defend with this card. Big Eye, sometimes you can take control opponent monster. Dragosak is really strong. You can tribute itself, and you can summon Vendor or Unicorn from hand. Next, this. Tekarnet, why I use this because you can detach one of this material, then target opponent card, destroy it, then you can banish one card from grave. So if you have Papias in grave, you can banish it with this. You can combo with this card with Papias. Also, if you have Shifter, if you already use Shifter, you can banish it. And you can use another Shifter from hand. So the good part about this is it can banish one card from your grave, so you can enter combo with in this Papias, Shifter, or this Big Bang. Number 89, this is a main combo to banish opponent extra deck and appeal to banish opponent top deck like 4 or 8, depend with your opponent banish face down card. Red Eyes, just in case in time, maybe. You can make this, and let's say your opponent only have like 1000 or 500 life point, you can make this in main phase 2, and yeah, it's just win the game with this card. Next, reset, I think 2 is enough because you can easy to make this in mirror match. Let's say opponent use Shangri-La, you can face summon this with either your Kassira monster. And you can, it's like Transia in your deck, but instead of destroy, you can banish opponent. You can banish one card on the field. So this is really really strong card. Next, to Zeus, because it's not limited in TCG. I don't know why it's still only in TCG. Yeah, sometimes you can banish one of this with Prosperity, and you can still another one. And let's say opponent try to banish your extra deck. They have under choice. They have good under choice because you have Zeus, 2 Zeus. When they try to banish one of this, you still have another one. So 2 Zeus is mandatory, I think. And next, set deck, I think I will move into spell first. It's still in testing, so I still not sure about in this this card. Change of heart, I think this is for mirror. Mind control is for mirror too. And there also it's a good. So yeah, still you can search it with this tasking. And if you don't like it, you can change this card with the deck rule. Next tester for big rotate. Zombie world, I think it's for flow. Because you play because AP Terra plus set protection, I think it's fine to have these two. Secret village, I think you can use this when you going first, and you can make a big eye because it's spellcaster, and yeah, it stop opponent to opponent like Dark Rule or droplet or something. It's still testing in here because this is another lock opponent spell. Next, definitely when you going second, you can use this against any deck. Next, Three Solemn, it's really must in this deck. When you going first, you can get opponent evenly, droplet or deck rule. And next, a pointer, it help you a lot against like spear mode, lava column. When they try to to triple your oven monster, you can get a opponent hand with it. Also, this is I think this is a good card. This one, this Light Force Swords. So this is really old card. And because I use this because the pointer is limit in TCG, and you can use this in true base. So the effect is banish one random card opponent hand face down, and during the standby, during the fourth standby after this card activation, return that card to the hand. So it's similar like a pointer, but you banish opponent randomly. With a pointer, these two have a good interaction with Rest Heart, because let's say you banish your opponent card with this, and you can attach that card with this Rest Heart, so it will not return in your opponent hand if you attach it with Rest Heart. Also, because it's banish face down, you can trigger Shangri-La with it and trigger this number 89. So this card is really really strong. So in first game, in first turn, usually you can lock 3 opponent zone. Also with this one like force, you can trigger Shangri-La. You can banish one face down and channeling one Shangri-La and channeling to this Diabolus. It also trigger Diabolus. And you can you can lock opponent 5 zone with it. So channeling one Shangri-La, channeling to Diabolus, and it will banish opponent top deck again. And after this result, Shangri-La will trigger it again because this Diabolus effect, so it will lock opponent 5 zone. So I think lock opponent spell or trap zone is better than monster zone if you open this. So this is really really good combo and strong combo. I think that's it. We have a good list in here. I think for side, still working on it. And for man, I think it's I think I still looking to take out this tasking. It's only good when you going second, but yeah, so far it's good. So that's it. This is a Castle Art example if you want to play this after Potomac Nova release. And yeah, thank you for listening, and see you on the next one.